Yeah, we finally made it, man. You don't tell me, Lee, I'll see you, baby. Against all odds, we ride. The top is so much better than the
world. It's your boy, Big Clev. I'm from Dallas, Texas. What's good? Well, I was born in Dallas, Texas. Grew up in the southeast part of Dallas, Texas, which we know it as Pleasant Grove. I've been in the Grove all my life, you know what I'm saying? I went from elementary to middle school to high school, you know, from Tights to Fred F. Florence to W.W. Sammy. I grew up in the Grove, you know what I'm saying? That's where I've been all my life. I mean, I had family and around all of Dallas, you know what I'm saying? Like South Dallas, North Dallas, Oak Cliff, a lot of family on my daddy's side in West Dallas. So you can pretty much say that I got all of Dallas in me pretty much, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't really just, you know, some people I know in the hood, you know what I'm saying, they grew up in Oak Cliff and they just stayed in Oak Cliff. I mean, pretty much everybody's hood in Dallas, you can pretty much get anything you want in that neighborhood, you know what I'm saying? Whether it's a car, whether it's some work, or whether it's, you know, food or whatever, you know what I'm saying? So a lot of OGs in Dallas didn't have to venture too far out their neighborhood. So, you know, I really could do that, you know what I'm saying? If you know me, you know me, you know what I'm saying? You might know me from over there in Oak Cliff or West Dallas or South Dallas. I'd be all over, but my main hood, man, is Pleasant Grove. That's pretty much where I got my first battle wounds, you know what I'm saying, where I got my hands, you know, where I, you know, learned the game from. Pleasant Grove, that's where I'm from, that's my hood. Well, growing up in the Grove was pretty tough, you know what I'm saying? Like every major hood in Dallas, you know what I'm saying? Every major city got a hood that's known for banging, selling drugs, or, you know, just anything you can think of that's hood, you know what I'm saying? I mean, Pleasant Grove was one of them hoods that if you didn't do music, you banged. If you didn't bang, you played sports, you know what I'm saying? It really wasn't that many opportunities for you. You just really had to have your mind set, you know what I'm saying? And with me, you know, my dad was a pastor, so, and my mom was an evangelist, you know what I'm saying? But she also sung, you know what I'm saying? And with me, I had the privilege of having that godliness, you know what I'm saying, in me, you know what I'm saying, at an early age. You know, a lot of people, a lot of my friends didn't have that. You know, they didn't have their fathers or they didn't have their mothers, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, growing up without a father, it's kind of hard for you to do a lot of the good things that people was expecting us to do, you know what I'm saying? So when you went to the Grove, you know what I'm saying, it was E-Greedy, man. That's where E-Greedy came from, because we also know, you know, the Grove was known as, you know, the Greedy Grove. So when you hear the words E-Greedy, that came from Pleasant Grove. No matter what nobody say, it came out the Grove. They've been saying it ever since 89, man. But yeah, I mean, you know, that's all we was doing, man. I mean, a lot of people, if you're from Dallas, you know that when you come to Pleasant Grove, you gotta lock your doors. You gotta lock your doors, you gotta, I mean, cause Pleasant Grove, that's all they do, man. They bang, you know what I'm saying, sell drugs. It was just that kind of life, you know what I'm saying?
I'm from Texas, home of the lost.
First time I got introduced to music was in church. You know what I'm saying? I was 2 years old, and my brother was a drummer. All my brothers was drummers, and some kind of producer or something like that. So even my uncle played the saxophone. One of my uncles played the piano and sung. You know what I'm saying? My mom even traveled. She had a group called the Golden Voices that was made up. My cousins, aunties, even grandma got up there and sung. And we used to go city to city, traveling, singing, and church to church in that little local neighborhood we singing and different things. So at 2 years old, I was already performing in front of a lot of people, you know what I'm saying? I never forget, the first time I got introduced to music was, we used to have a praise service at church, and I was 2 years old, and my mama and daddy, I always knew that I could hold a beat at church because I used to get pots and pans, man, and little boxes. I used to beat all over the house, man, make a noise, you know what I'm saying? My dad always told me, boy, you got something special in you that you need to share, you know what I'm saying? So he told me even when I was 2 years old how my brother used to put me in his lap doing offering, you know what I'm saying, at church. And I used to play the drums in his lap at 2 years old and keep a beat. You know, so I went to a church, the neighborhood church, which was in West Dallas, which was Greenway Park Church of God in Christ, under late Reverend Fennel. And that's where I got my start. That's where I first fell in love with music, man, was in the church. I started playing the drums, and then on later, you know, so when I got in elementary, you know, so I was in elementary, I was playing the trumpet. I was first church trumpet, you know what I'm saying? And then I went from the trumpet to junior high. I played the trumpet again, and they really wouldn't give me an opportunity. I used to tell them all the time, man, I know how to play drums. I played drums in church. And I'll never forget, you know, my band director, which was Mr. Frank Flemings. He was like, hey, well, you gonna play the trumpet. I never heard you play drums, so, you know what I'm saying? Long story short, I got the opportunity to play the drums, man, and I wowed them, you know what I'm saying? I've been playing drums ever since, you know what I'm saying? I moved from the drums to the guitar, to the bass guitar, and then, you know what I'm saying, I moved to the keyboard and the organ. I just kind of ventured out like that, man, but church was my first, you know, fell in love with me. I would say that it's kind of hard. Yeah, it's hard coming from the South and being an independent artist because, I mean, you got everything against you, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't like the way we talk. They say that we country bounders. They think we down here riding on horses, and that's not the case, you know what I'm saying? I would say that one of the biggest reasons why it's so hard because, I mean, when you go to them other cities, you know what I'm saying, they got major labels right there in their city. So all they have to do is just really just go across the street. If they got a mixtape or something, you know what I'm saying, that they want to present, all they got to do is just go to the building and present it. Us, we got to go through that chain of command, you know what I'm saying? We got to deal with all that bull crap, you know what I'm saying? All these shady DJs, shady promoters and A&Rs, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, but it's some good DJs and some good promoters out there and some good A&Rs, but majority of them is shady and they all about the money. So, if, you know, you got to deal with, you know, just getting set up to the point of for, you know, to even present your music. You know what I'm saying? That's the hardest part, just being connection, just to get your music heard. You know what I'm saying? And you got thousands of people doing the same thing you trying to do. You know what I'm saying? You got, every day, it's like 1,000 more producers, or 1,000 more rappers, or 1,000 more artists that's trying to make it. And you know, it's hard for us being from the South because the simple fact is, you know, I know coming where I came from, out of Dallas, you know what I'm saying? Most of the people growing up, you know, Dallas is a hood. I mean, it's not that stuff you see on TV, you know, especially in my hood, Pleasant Grove. It's the hood, brother. You hear me? I'm talking about they still got jet lag spinning, you know what I'm saying? And growing out of there, it's easy for you to get a felony at an early age. And you know how hard it is to get a job and you a felon. So a lot of these dudes have skills. I'm talking about your play, bro. I'm talking about, man, I met dudes that sell ice water on the football field, man. It's crazy, unbelievable. You know what I'm saying? Even with music, you know what I'm saying? They can rap, you know what I'm saying? Freestyle, man, like they enroll it, you know what I'm saying? But the thing is, it's so many things that's against us, you know, just to get set up in that position to be heard, you know what I'm saying? And while you trying to transition to that position, you know, you got to face a lot of stuff on the streets, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't make it out, you know what I'm saying? They don't make it out the hood, they don't make it to just to get their stuff heard. And, you know, a lot of people get disappointed. And they just say they either quit or just say forget it, go back out to the streets. But that's why I think it's harder for the South, man, because we don't have the same opportunities that, you know, the East Coast or the West Coast have. We don't have that. I get the name Big Clev. It's a crazy story. I am a crazy story. I was in the studio with my homeboy one day. I was working on a track. It was a banging track. I'll never forget it. You know, I like to do a lot of melodic stuff in my tracks, whether it's, you know, pianos and live bass guitars. And I'll put guitars up in there. Put some live keys up in there, different things like that. So, I mean, the people that was in the studio at the time, they was loving the track. I mean, it was banging, man. It put chills in. And he was like, dang, that's a clever track, man. And I was like, what you say? He said, man, you be doing some clever stuff, boy, you clever. So from that day on, I pretty much just ran with it, you know what I'm saying? I started naming myself Clever, you know what I'm saying? And I was already kind of, I've been on the plump side, so I just put Big Clev, you know what I'm saying? That's how I got the name Big Clev. Yeah, people know me because my name is Preston, but people know me by Big Clev. So if you wondering, that's how I got my name, Big Clev. Clev stands for Clever.